Hello students, on my previous video I had already discussed about the process microsporogenesis. So what is microsporogenesis? Microsporogenesis is the process of the formation of microspores or pollen grains inside the pollen chambers or pollen sacs, that is also known as microsporangium of an anther. And after formation of microspores, they are arranged in tetrad forms, and on maturity these microspores are getting separated from tetrads and forming individual mature pollen grains or microspores. So these tetrads or microspore tetrads are of following types. Today I will discuss about first the microspore tetrads. What are the types of microspore tetrads? The first one, tetrahedral form. Tetrahedral. In tetrahedral form, four microspores are arranged in such a way. 1, 2 and 3, 3 microspores or pollen grains, and the fourth one is present just at the back side of the third one. So this is the first microspore, this is second, and this is third one, and fourth one is present just at the back side of the third one. Three microspores here and the fourth one present at the back side of third one. It is the tetrahedral form of microspore tetrads. Next, second one is known as isobilateral form. In case of isobilateral, four microspores are arranged in this way. This is first, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth. All four microspores are arranged in this way. It is isobilateral form. Next, third one. Third one is known as decasset form. Decasset form means 1, 2, this is third, and fourth one is present at the backside of third one. It is first, second, third. First microspore, second microspore, third microspore, fourth one present just opposite side of the third one. It is decasset form. Next, fourth one is T-shaped. T-shaped. T-shaped means this is first, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth microspore. And T-shaped, in case of T-shaped tetrad, the four microspores are arranged in such a way. And the fifth one is known as linear. So what is about linear? Linear means 1, 2, 3 and 4. In a linear form, four microspores are arranged. So this is all about microspore tetrads. First one tetrahedral, second one isobilateral, third one decasset, fourth one T-shaped, and the fifth one is linear form. Okay, so this is all about microspore tetrads. Next, I will discuss about the structure of microspore or pollen grains. Microspore or pollen grains. Microspores may be of different shapes and size. First, microspores is the, we all know the microspore is the first cell of the male gametophyte. From the microspore, the male gametophyte will be developed, and within the male gametophyte, male gametes are formed. There are two male gametes in angiosperms, and in each male gametophyte, two male gametes will be formed. And from this microspore, the male gametophyte will be developed. So this is the first cell of male gametophyte. And what is about the shape and size of microspores? Now, microspores are of different shapes and size. It may be ellipsoidal, circular, oval, or somewhat elongated. Sometimes the microspores may be in triangular shape, etc. And the outer wall of microspore is known as sporoderm. The sporoderm is the wall of microspore. It is the wall of microspore. Sporoderm. Clear. And the sporoderm can be classified into two categories. First one, exine, and the second one intine. Clear. And the intine layer, it is a thin delicate layer, and the exine is very hard outer membrane of the microspore. And intine layer, also known as pectocellulose membrane. Why it is known as pectocellulose membrane? Because intine is made up of pectin as well as cellulose. Both are present, pectin and cellulose. That is why it is known as pectocellulose membrane. And it is the thin, very much delicate innermost membrane. And the outer layer is known as exine. Exine again can be classified into two parts, ectexine and endexine. Ectexine and endexine. Ectexine is the outer layer of the exine and endexine is the inner layer of exine. Ectexine also known as sexine and endexine is also known as nexine. Clear? And ectexine can be again classified into three parts. The innermost layer of ectexine is known as foot layer. Innermost layer mainly known as foot layer. Clear? It is foot layer. And the middle layer of ectexine is known as baculate layer and the outermost layer is tectum. So it is middle layer is known as baculate layer and the outermost layer is known as tectum. So exine can be classified into two, ectexine or sexine and endexine or nexine. Ectexine is again can be classified into three parts, innermost layer, foot layer, middle layer, baculate layer and the first but outer layer is known as tectum. And in tectum layer very much cultures are present. And in case of exine, and chemical or organic matter is present. Organic matter. This organic matter is known as sporopollenin. So what is the function of sporopollenin? Mainly sporopollenin is very much resistant organic matter or organic material. It keeps the pollen grains resistant from high temperature, acid and alkali. So it is the function of sporopollenin. And you have to practice the structure of pollen grain from your book, okay? So let me discuss about the structure of pollen grain, diagram of structure of pollen grain. It is first it is exine and it is intine. And some pore-like structures are present on the outer wall. These pores are known as germ pores. And each microspores or pollen grains having two cells and each cells having one nucleus. It is generative cell, another one vegetative cell or tube cell. Vegetative cell or tube cell having tube nucleus and generative cell having generative nucleus. And in the outer wall some sculpturings are present and this is germ pore. Germ pore, pore like structure. And these are the various types of sculptures present in microspores or pollen grains and these are the various shapes of pollen grains. Okay, in my next video I will discuss about the formation of male gametophyte from these pollen grains.